Hi guys, welcome to Talk Crypto. In today's video, we're gonna talk a little bit more about Neon Labs. This video is not a financial advice. This video is just for educational and entertainment purpose only, so please do your own research. All the links are mentioned in the description box below. Please don't forget to hit the like, comment, and subscribe to watch more of such videos. Without further ado, let's get into it. Alright, so this is the website of Neo Labs. You can access it by going to neo-labs.org. So Neo is a really cool stuff because it kind of combines the idea of two chains. So we have Solana and we have Ethereum. As per the website, it is an Ethereum virtual machine which has scalability and liquidity like that of Solana, and it has one of the lowest gas fees. So as you can see, it is 0.0015 SOL per TX and 4500 TPS high throughput, which is pretty impressive. I think it's a really cool concept because Ethereum and Solana are like one of the two biggest giants competing against each other, but the fact that they are combining them together in one environment is really cool. With Ethereum infrastructure, it brings in accounts and signatures, tools and infrastructure, ETH like WEB3, RPC API, ETH ERC20 tokens, Solidity smart contracts. But with Solana blockchain, it brings liquidity, user base, TX record in Solana, lightning fast TX. So that's really cool. You can also start learning more about them by checking out their white paper document and checking them out on GitHub. Some of the benefits of Neon EVM is the scalability. So you get lower gas fees, you get a high transaction speed of Solana. You can also grow on Solana's liquidity, meaning you get access to all of these SOL tokens. You get access to native Solana assets like USDC and other bridged assets. It's the first EVM on Solana, so you can discover various advantages related to it being the first mover, and you can reach out to new customers. It also facilitates easy smart contract adoption, so you can deploy Ethereum dApps without any reconfiguration of smart contracts. You can also get familiar smart contract languages, so you can write your dApps in languages you know, such as Solidity or Viper. And you can also use tools that you are already familiar with, like MetaMask and Truffle. The best thing about Neo EVM is that it is fee-based. So Neo will be a utility token and it will be used for various governance reasons. And on their Maniate launch, the governance will be essentially taken care of by a decentralized protocol, which has a clear and a user-friendly process for how to propose and vote on various improvements that can be made within the protocol. And here's the roadmap of the company. So there was a pre-alpha stage, which is where Neon EVM proof of concept, Neon EVM stabilization, indexing dashboard rollout was taking place. In the alpha stage, there will be a limited dApp testing, Neon pass rollout, Neon scan launch, and Mora swap deployment will take place. In the beta phase, there will be Neon DAO governance rollout, security audit shall be passed, Neon EVM shall be rolled out. In the gamma stage, Neon EVM full compatibility will take place, the NFT support will be available as well. You can also join their ecosystem and become an operator. You can run proxy, so that's really cool. And also for dApps, if you are a developer out there or a team who wants to build on Neon or integrate with it, you can also do that over here. The best thing is that you can scale your Ethereum dApps on Solana without requiring any changes to their code. You can interact with the dApps, you can also explore the documents just to get more insight about how it works, and you can build on dApp. So that is one of the really cool stuff about it. You can also run different Ethereum dApp on Neon. So DeFi, DEX, games, collectibles, which is coming soon, and many more options. If you're somebody out there who wants to scale your dApp on Solana, you need to check out Neon because it is the first and the only option and solution right now. And here's a little graphic that shows how it works. It shows the entire process, so a simplified model of how it's gonna go about. Then there's a little graphic that shows Neon EVM in much more detail about how it navigates. Also, they have a really cool community, which is a home for developers, token holders out there, operators, friends, and supporters from all around the world. So they are available on Discord, 15,000 members. Twitter has 28,000 members. Reddit has 900 members. The blog readers has 500 plus members. The Telegram has 2,000 members. The GitHub has 150 plus stars. So that's really cool because community is very important when the project is new and upcoming. It just helps and facilitates and like spreads the word out. You can can also get rewarded simply for finding a bug or any sort of vulnerability in the Neon, and you can kind of report it to them. If you want to do that, you can click over here. So essentially, operators out there would run Neon proxy, which would allow very seamless execution of Ethereum like transactions on Solana, and this also allows the Ethereum dApps to be kind of ported to Neon without requiring any change of code. So if you want to become an operator, you can do that. You can click run proxy and go through this document to learn a bit more about how it works and all of that. And here is an explorer of Neon Scan. You can access it by going to neonscan.org. You can search for hash, account, token, block, anything you want. And over here, you'll have a market tab, which is going to show information about the Neon price, market cap. You'll have network information, the transactions that took place, the last block, the transactions that took place over a different period of time. You can have more information about the statistics, the accounts, the token, the TPS, operators, and all of that. You can also see latest transactions over a certain period of time and also the latest blocks. You can also click over here to swap from Mani, Testnet, or DevNet. So that's a fun way to swap between different platforms. You can also transfer the SLP tokens that you have between Solana and Neon by clicking to this link. So it's going to take you to Neon Pass. So next, you will come to this page where you can exchange your Solana tokens into Neon. You can swap it as well if you want to go it either way. The next step would be to connect to a wallet. So if you have a MetaMask wallet, you can integrate with it like so. Once the MetaMask wallet is connected, you can click next and follow the prompts. I don't really want to do that, but that's essentially how you would go about the process. So Neon Lab basically aims to bring both scalability and low transaction cost of Solana to an ecosystem of Ethereum dApps, developers, and end users. So that's a bit about it. And here's the team who's working behind the project. So we have Marina, who is the CEO. We have Andre, who is the CDO. We have Konstantin, who is the COO. We have James, who is the head of strategy and business division, and so on. So that's a good thing that they do have their pictures over here and what they do, because I really like to see the people who are working behind the project, because it just gives it more credibility and makes the project look a lot more legit, a lot more trustable, and a lot more reliable. So we have Marina over here. You can also click over here and check them out on LinkedIn just to have more context on how it works. All right, and this is the Twitter page of Neon Labs, and as you can see, they do have a following of 30.9k followers, which is pretty impressive because it's a new project. And over here, they make regular updates about the new stuff that they are working on, so definitely worth checking out to stay tuned with the community, to stay tuned with Neon Labs. So overall, I feel the idea of combining Ethereum and Solana and putting them together to bring a system that is more scalable is very futuristic, and it does have a lot of potential to grow and scale. I'm really excited to see all the stuff Neon Labs shall do in future, so stay tuned for that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, found it helpful. Please don't forget to hit the like, comment, and subscribe, and I shall see you guys in my next one. Till then, take care. Bye.